we realize that a lot of times when people come to Soweto, they just, you know, it's people who don't stay there and they take pictures of Soweto, and we don't agree with those pictures, you know. It's not always such bad pictures or poverty. There's good things happening in Soweto as well. So we decided to take pictures of the Soweto that we like, the Soweto that we see, that we know, that we grew up in.
Yeah.
So from there, we took the pictures and we put them on Tumblr.
Yeah.
That was the first platform we used. We put them on Tumblr and people started engaging in the pictures. People started liking the pictures. And we couldn't believe it, you know, because so many people could recognize those places, you know. People were proud, were suddenly proud of where they came from. Someone would be like, oh, that's my hometown, or that's where I grew up in, you know. Or get someone from New York would comment and be like, oh, I know that street, you know. And then from there, we just ended up pushing more, shooting a lot of pictures. And it was tough because we had a day job. We used to work 9 to 5. And after 5, that's when we started shooting our pictures. And weekends, we started shooting as well. So it was tough juggling the two. But if it's something you love, it doesn't feel like a job.
We have no formal training at all. We are totally self-taught, and we learn from mentors, learn from friends. We all started a short course, photography course for 8 months, dropped out. And yeah, everything that we know and what we do is all self-taught, and we just research on the internet, buy books that will always teach us what we wanna do. Yeah, so no formal education at all, just self-taught and passionate about what we like to do and give it 100%.
We met in church, actually. It's a funny story, because in my church, in our church, actually, they used to speak Venda. They Venda and I'm Xhosa. I don't understand Venda, so I used to daydream every time we went to church, you know. I never used to listen because I can't hear what the pastor's saying. So, and then Innocent comes to me, he's like, hey, I'm Innocent. And I'm like, hi, I'm Innocent. And I look back, because I'm daydreaming, I'm not there. And then Justice comes to me, he's like, oh, hi, I'm Justice. I'm like, hi, I'm Justice. And then these guys never spoke to me ever again. And then I met them 2 weeks later at the library.
We
were skating, not inside the library. We didn't like books at the time. We were skating outside the library. And then I saw the guys and we started speaking. Then from there, we were friends. I think I was 8 at the time.
He was 8, we were 12, yeah. And then we just became friends and brothers. We're practically brothers. We do everything together and we just feed off each other, you know. On our side, for myself and Justice, it was very tricky because we had a very supporting mother who believed in everything that we work that we do, supporting brother and sister. So they've always seen that we were like too energetic. We were into sports. We were into all these other things besides studying. And we had a chat with our moms and we told her that, you know what, we are not going to be lawyers or doctors. We are artists. It's either we'll be great artists or we'll be great sportsmen. But we promise you, we will make it in any of those things. And then she just said, okay, guys, whatever you want to do, do it. But promise me one thing, don't be failures in life. Don't find yourself sitting in the corner and just drinking or taking drugs. Be successful. If you can promise me that, you can do whatever you want. And we had that pressure to prove to her that what we love is real and it will make us real people or great one day, which we're still working on that.
If there's people out there that are doing it, why can't you?
And don't be afraid to ask. You know, you can be whatever you want to be and dream big.